Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So, now, this is probably like a different setup for you guys, because it is, and it's going to be a different kind of video. So, I'm going to be packing for a trip. Sorry, I'm really out of breath, I just ran up the stairs, so excuse me for a second. But yeah, so I'm going to be packing. I'm not going to be packing into the bags, I'm just going to like be getting everything ready, clothes-wise. My mum's going to put it in like the suitcase. For me, but like books I'm going to pack into my own bag and stuff like that. So yeah, I thought I'd bring you guys along with me, and I might be vlogging the trip. I'll see how I feel and I'll see how things go. But yeah, so I'm just going to start off with the clothes, I think, and then move on to like the books and little other bits. Now, some things I won't be able to pack until like the day, but it's fine. Like hairbrush and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm going to, like I said, start with the clothes. Okay, so start off with the clothes. I don't know how well you're going to see me, but this is the best angle I can get. That doesn't look terrible. And my fan is on, so you're gonna have to mind that. But yeah, I might just time lapse it a bit, because I do want to listen to music while I do this, and obviously I don't want to get copyrighted, so yeah, that's the plan. Calling, oh hey, oh yeah, be telling, I body your style, every small thing, look in your eyes, know you want me. Also put away a pair of clothes for me to actually change and stuff. So yeah, I think I've done the clothes bit now, and now I've just gotta do like the books and stuff, because I leave, how many days? Friday, Saturday, Sunday, 3 days. So I've got to sort out some books. I've already got loads of books that I've gotta read within 3 days, so I'm not too worried about it, to be honest. And I've already got a pile ready, but there are some few that I was thinking about taking, so I'm just gonna decide now. But first, I gotta go downstairs, so I'll be back in a second. Okay, so now my clothes are in the suitcase. Now, like I just said, now I'm gonna do books. My hair's up, it's way too hot, So these are the books that I've decided already on. So I've got The Noise. I bought this recently. Sounds good. And I mean, why not? Then I got Remember Me. This is also like a thriller mystery, like the other one, I didn't mention that. It's also saying good. It's a paranormal book, I think. I'm showing you guys quickly. Then this is my mom's book, which I'm gonna put in my bag for her. Although I do want to read this one day myself. Then I've got The Teacher, which is also like a mystery thriller. It's about a head teacher who is found hanging from the rafters, and they've got to like figure out who did it. And then I got these two summary books because I didn't want to just take all mystery thrillers. I also wanted some romance and like cute summer reads. So I've got Every Summer After by Carly Fortune. I have been saving this for this trip for so long, so that's why I'm taking it. I've wanted to read it this month so bad, but I had to keep putting it off. And it's a nice short read. And then I've got The Summer of Broken Rules. And I've also heard that this is a really good one, so I've also been saving this one for then as well. So I don't know, I do want to take more books. I don't think those are just going to do, but I don't know what ones. Like when I look at my shelf, I'm like, what do I take? It's just so overwhelming. I don't want to take books that like I can reread. I don't want to reread anything. I want like new experiences. So what's this book? Not a Happy Family. In this family, everyone is keeping secrets, even the dead and the quiet, wealthy, and clever. Oh! An older couple is brutally murdered hours after a tense Easter dinner with their three adult children, who, of course, are devastated, or are they? Each stands in to inherit millions. They were never a happy family, thanks to their vindictive father and neglectful mother, but perhaps one of them is more disturbed than anyone knew. Oh, that could be a good one. And the font is quite big, so I should get through this quite quickly. I can tell. I also want to try and take books that I can maybe like vlog myself reading, but I don't want to base my reading off vlogging. I do that enough at home. So, I've also got some down here, which I've had for quite a while. So I have Stop at Nothing, but what's this actually about? A mother's job is to keep her children safe. Tess has always tried to be a good mother, of course. There are things she wishes she'd done differently, but doesn't everyone feel that way? Then Emma, her youngest, is attacked on her way home from a party, plunging them into a living nightmare, which only gets worse when the man responsible is set free. But what if she fails? So when Tess sees the attacker on the street near their home, she's forced to take matters into her own hands, but blinded by her need to protect her daughter at any cost, might she end up putting her family in even greater danger? Oh, I never actually read this before, I just picked it up. Okay, I could take that one. I made a mistake. You've probably seen me talking about these two books in vlogs before around October time. Never got around to them, even though I talked about them a lot. So, if I remember correctly, these two did sound good as well. So, I could take those and finally read them as well. Now, what I was thinking about taking as well, but I can get on Kindle Unlimited, and I don't want to carry around paperbacks if I don't need to, is like, what's this, the Dirty Air series. I can get these on Kindle Unlimited, so I might just read them on Kindle Unlimited, and it saves me having to take the physical copy, well, physical copies, because it's four. So yeah, I might just read them on Kindle Unlimited. It might make more sense. I was thinking about taking Midnight Library as it's a nice short read as well. How many pages is this? 288, so this shouldn't take me long. I tried reading this a couple of months ago, it just wasn't the right time. Nora's life has been going from bad to worse at the stroke of midnight. On her last day on Earth, she finds herself transported to a library. There she's given the chance to undo her regrets and try out each of the other lives she might have lived, which raises the ultimate question, with infinite choices, which is the best way to live? So I could take that one as well. Is there any romance books that I can take? Romance books, I've read majority of them on my shelf, so I could just, if I wanted to, like, read them on my Kindle. I've also got loads on my tablet as well. So I have loads digitally. I've just saw that I have this one, the Bad Boy and the Tomboy, which I did start a couple of months ago, never actually got into it, so I could just restart reading this again. I don't remember what actually happened. So I might take that. It's originally a Wattpad book. It's about Macy Anderson and what's his name? Macy Anderson has always been one of the guys and is forced on only three things: studying, soccer, and the scholarship. Romance is the last thing on her mind. That is until her friend Cedric, handsome and crisp, and the only boy she's ever had a crush on, asks her out. There's just one problem: Sam, Cedric's cousin, is brazen and unapologetic, with a bad boy reputation to match, and he has annoying ways of constantly showing up in Macy's life. Sounds good. As long as it's not a love triangle. I haven't heard much about this, but we'll see. When I hopefully read it. I don't want to take too much, but I keep like seeing things that pop out at me, like this. This is also another short, nice and short one, which I've been meaning to read. I Love You, I Hate You. It's kind of like The Hating Game, I think, where they work together, but they're enemies. So enemies to lovers. Yeah, Victoria and Owen are bitter rivals. Nora and Luke are friends online. Who will believe these two couples have anything in common? Oh, it's just about two couples. I thought it was just about one. Okay. Although there is a lot of writing on this page. That's okay. We'll take it. There's a lot of books on my bed right now. Okay. Read loads of Colleen Hoover, and I also have Colleen Hoover on every device. Soulmates, I've been meaning to read for a long time, but that might be a bit too thick for me. Look how thick this is. Although the writing is quite big. Every so often, two people are born with who are the perfect match for one another, soulmates, but what if meeting your soulmate is literally shattering literally? It's earthly shattering literally. I mean, no, it's a bit too thick. I don't want to be putting pressure on myself like that. I also have this on my tablet, so I don't need to take this copy. Don't want to be carrying things that I don't need to when I have it digitally. Is that all? I was thinking about taking a permanent record, but from what I've heard, it just seems like a depressing book for a holiday. Oh, I wanted to take this series, actually. And I have some books in the other room that I want to take, so I need to be careful. Get a Life, Chloe Brown, Take Ain't Dinner Brown, and Actor Age, E. Brown. I might try and get some of these on my Kindle or something. Like, I might try and lower the pile, because what I have on my bed, plus what I want to take that's in that room, it's quite a lot, so I'm going to show you. This is what I have on my bed so far. It's a lot, plus I have loads in the other room, so I might just try and get as much as I can on my Kindle or tablet or whatever. I've got to figure it out, but yeah, that's a lot. I do actually have everything like after on my Kindle as well, but I really like floppy, like this paperback. It's nice and floppy, so I do want to take this one, definitely. And I mean, I bought it, so. Anyway, I have been rambling on about books. Those are the ones I want to take for now. But yeah, there might be some more. So I'm going to put those in a bag, and I've got to figure it out. Actually, no, what I'm going to go and do is I'm going to see if I can actually get them on my Kindle before I pack them. Because otherwise I'm going to have to unpack it, and it's just a lot. And I might try and get some of the other books in there and show you guys them as well. So yeah. I'm going to go do that, and I'll be back. Okay, so I was able to get quite a few of the piles that I had on my Kindle, but the only problem is I went in there, got the books that I wanted to take, and now the pile is even higher than it was. So, I've got to think of this logically. If I can't fit all the books in to the bag, I can't take them. So, it's fine. But the ones I was able to get on my Kindle was Noise, so I don't need to take that one anymore. Stop It, I think. not a happy family. I'm so sorry, but my dog is just staring at me from around the corner. Hi. Then I made a mistake. The guilty dead. And then, whoops. And then the Brown Sisters trilogy. So I don't need to take them, because I have them. But the ones that I just got out of the other room, it's a whole stack, and I just brought them in all in one go, and it's a very, very dangerous situation. But I am going to bring my Heartstopper colouring book, because it's just amazing and it gives me something to do. Then these are the books that I've got to be responsible with. So I want to take The Soulmate Equation, because I've been meaning to read this for a long time. Josh and Hazel's Guide to Dating, which I did start. I'm a lot further into it than this. I just haven't moved the bookmark. I'm not sure how far I am into it though. But it's the one that I kept reading at my nan's when I went. So, that one. Where the Crawdads Sing, because I'm pretty sure, is it a show, movie, whatever. It came out recently, unless I haven't read the book. But before I watch it, I want to read the book. So I've got to read it. I don't want to read Red, White and Royal Blue, because, again, been meaning to read it for a very, very long time. I haven't got around to it, so hopefully this will be my time. Then, The Anti-Boyfriend by Penelope Ward. This I started, I just haven't completed it because I am annotating it. It's taken me forever and it put me off kind of, so I have come up with a plan in my head. So hopefully I can start reading this again. Book Lovers by Emily Henry. Good Girl Complex by Elle Kennedy. Then I want to take Darling of Venom, because I've heard so many great things about this and I just want to read it. But I did want to vlog this, so maybe I could do like a holiday reading vlog. I don't know. We'll see. Then I want to take Malibu Rising by Taylor Jenkins Reid, because this is also a summer read and I just think it will be fun. Then I want to take the second, third and fourth book in the Briar U series, which is a spin-off series of the off-campus series. I've read The Chase. It was great. I loved it. But I am vlogging these as well, so we'll see how that goes, shall we? And then, Two for Joy by Zoe Sugg and Amy McCullough. So, I have started this, I just haven't continued. Those are all the books I'm taking. How am I going to get all this in the bag? I don't know. So this is the bag I'm hoping to fit all those books in. It is really big, I must admit. But I also want to put other things in here, other than book. It's going to be very, very heavy. I didn't think of the heaviness, actually. Maybe I won't be able to take all these books. Am I being ridiculous? Let me know. Am I being unreasonable? Maybe. But we're going to try and get them all in. If I can't, I can't. There's nothing I can do. But yeah, so I've got this big compartment and then three other compartments. This, it goes smaller each time. So how am I gonna do this? I don't know. It's too many books. Should I put in piles of like things that I want to prioritize and put those in? Should I do that? Okay, hold on, I'm gonna change the angle. Okay, this is the angle we are working with. I'm gonna get down. Oh, so these are all the books, as you can see. Didn't think this through, did I? Nope. No, I didn't. But have the bag down here. It looks so tiny. So what do I want to prioritize taking? Okay, so I definitely want to take these two. Those are like priorities because I've been waiting to read them. Purposely for this. So I'll put those on the floor as prioritize. I also do kind of want to prioritise this one, and I do want to prioritise The Teacher, Remember Me, and obviously my mum's book. So, those are prioritations, that's not a word. Oh, I also want to prioritise this one because I want to get this read. These ones I don't really need to take, the Briar U series. But I do want to. okay. Let me think.
do also want to prioritize this. I mean, I'm going to be gone for 2 weeks. Okay, these two I want to also prioritize. This one I want to prioritize, and I want to also prioritize this one. Okay, I'm going to say those are my. Oh, I'm both at this. So, those are the important ones. If I could fit any of the others in, that is going to be brilliant. But if I can't, then I can't. So, I'm going to have to change angle again so you can see me. Okay, so this is no better of an angle, but it's better than it was. So, I have all the books down here. I have the bag here. So I'm going to do a time lapse of me putting them in the bag. Bag is looking like, whether it'll close or not, I don't know, but that is literally stacked up. What I keep forgetting is that I'm actually going to have to carry this. So it's fine. Oh, it zips up. Now I didn't get these in, so whether I'm gonna take them or not, I don't know, but I've got 3 more pockets. Whoa. Okay, that is really heavy. See, I'm just gonna put these to the side for now and I will think about them and see if I actually do want to take them or not. But I literally can't fit any more books in. So now I just need to pack all of like the small things that I'm not going to be using yet. Hold on, does that make sense? I don't know. Okay. I've been packing for hours now. So I need to move this heavy bag. And then I'm going to sort out my other stuff. Okay, so you can't actually see what I'm doing, but I'm in this drawer right here. But I can't pack my hairbrush yet. Although actually I could probably use another hairbrush for a couple of days. Because I do have this one, and I'm pretty sure I have more, even though they're rather disgusting, to be honest. Haven't used that one in years. But I could pack this one. This is the one I use. So I could pack it. Should I just take this whole drawer out? Might make more sense. I'm sorry, my sister's acting really crazy behind the camera. So that's why I'm laughing. Okay. What else can I say? Oh, I have a lot more hairbrushes than I thought. I'm gonna bring you down a notch. Down here. Hey! Okay, it's bad lighting. I'm sorry. But it's bad lighting. But I'm also gonna take this mirror because I think it'll be better than the one I have. Because you can actually like put this one somewhere. Sorry, it would make more sense. Then I've got some clips which I'm also gonna take because see this? Well, then my head's a mess at the moment, but they're my bangs, and I haven't sewn my bangs out, so I just clip them behind so they don't look like this, but I couldn't be bothered today. So, then I'm going to also take my dry shampoo because I want to. And then, what else can I take? I have loads of deodorants. Why did I say that? Deodorants. But I normally use this one. I don't think I've used this one in a while. It's something. And then I'm also going to take Oh, I smell that now. Now, and then I'm also gonna take this, which is the Ariana Grande perfume. Don't know what one it is, I forgot. I'm also gonna take this. Is it this one that I want? Yeah, it's this one that I want. And now I do have, I brought new hair bubbles yesterday, so I'm also gonna pack those. I don't have to pack, I'm also gonna pack these just in case I decide to do a hair style with it. Don't have to pack these, like hair clips. Oh, I definitely need to pack these. So these are my sunglasses, which I wear obviously when it's sunny, but I mean like I don't wear them that often. What am I saying? So they're these ones. Looking cool. Why are you laughing at me? Looking cool. So I'll put these aside and decide on them after. I don't see the point in taking like some out because I might lose them. Then I might take, I don't know what I use. What do I use? Oh, I have one of these rollers in there that I can take. Okay, I might take these two because they're just my vibes. And they're just nice when I just want to throw my hair up into something. I think that's it. Why are you laughing at me? And I do want to do a face mask over the weekend, so I might do that if I remember. But this is, I like to use the is it charcoal ones? So I have this one and I have this one. So I have these two. I might do this one. That's not the part of this video. Okay, I think that's it. If I find anything else during the days, I'll grab it. But that's it for now. That's done for now. That's really heavy. I was not exaggerating that either. So yeah, okay. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm sorry that this is very long, which I feel like it is going to be. Yeah. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please like it and subscribe if you want. It's free, and hope to see you all in my next video. Bye.